What's up, guys? GamerGodHD. If you guys are watching this video, you guys probably really want to get high score streaks in Call of Duty Advanced Warfare. So I've seen a lot of methods on YouTube, and they always involve either, like, you sit there and wait for all your assist points to add up, or you can use your care packages. This is, like, the legit way to get it, like, running around and getting kills and stuff like that. So if you guys are trying to reach that Warbird, the Goliath... Is it the Goliath? I don't think it's the Goliath anymore. Whatever that suit guy is. Or the Paladin, I think it's called. Watch this video. The gameplay that you're watching in the background, I go 15 and 3 and I get a Paladin. I don't think I get any kills with though, so it's kind of a fail. So I see so many people, they'll be on like 2% health and they'll still be running around the center of the maps, not even using their map or anything, and they'll try to take on guys with 100% health. Even if they get the first shot off, you're pretty much dead in that first shot. Don't be afraid to run away from gunfights. It's really a lot more important than you guys can imagine. I've died so many times trying to be brave and stuff, even though I'm sitting there like right all over my screen, you can barely even see. Don't do that. It's not smart. You can't camp. There's not really any buildings in this game that have just like one entrance. There's always like multiple entries, so it's a lot harder to camp. Plus, in this game, people are kind of getting smart, and they're starting to bring buddies with them. So I'd say 3 kills tops, and then you guys need to find either a new camping spot, or you need to just run around. Which brings me to my next point, is to not run into the highly populated areas of the map. So, most people get this confused with the centers of the map. It's not always the centers of the map. Riot, for example. Center of the map, 2 to 3 guys. Tops. Unless you're playing Domination, or something like that, and there's a flag in the middle of the map, or a hard point or something. Other than that, there's really not gonna be any people in the middle of the map. I use the middle of the map so many times to just, I don't know, just to get to their enemy side and start, not spawn trapping them, but yeah, kind of spawn trapping them. Yes, I'm that kind of player. So yeah, you guys don't wanna go through the highly populated area of the map. It's kind of a given. You guys also wanna use your maps. Okay, I know this seems pretty stupid, but that boulder sitting right there next to you while you're trying to kill this guy on 2% health, that boulder's not there to look pretty. That boulder's actually there to help you, so use it. Score streaks. I'm probably gonna make another video about this. You guys need to learn how to exo at the right time. What I mean by this is, exo suits are really loud, if you guys hadn't known those little... That noise, that's like really loud. Anybody that has their TV up really loud, or even just like a normal headset, can hear you. Yeah, you're not being sneaky at all. Unless you have that, like, one perk where it, like, doesn't make any noise or something. There's so much more tips that people don't even name. People are just think you can run around, use a good gun. Or not use a good gun. You can just, like, run around with any gun, do whatever you want, as long as you're using the maps and just running away from gunfights and you're not camping. No, it's a lot more than that. If you really want to get those high score streaks every single game, you have to take every single tip and put it into action in gameplay. That's not just use your map and use the right score streak setup and or use like an orbital care package and get the score streak from there. No, you guys have to work on aim. You gotta work on your accuracy. You gotta work on how you turn on people. You gotta find the right sensitivity and everything. But the one tip that I will give you is that you guys don't need to go out and buy control freaks or gun or glasses or anything like that, because in my opinion, they're kind of a big waste of money. I feel like you don't need that stuff to succeed in Call of Duty. Call of Duty wasn't made with control freaks. They've never came out with a Call of Duty that includes control freaks, as far as I'm concerned. You don't need them, okay? There's so many players that don't play without them, and they're really good. But yeah, guys, those are my tips on how to get a high score streak every single game. You gotta take in account every single thing that you've learned. Learn the maps, too. That's a really big one. But peace. See you guys soon. I turn my head to the sky. Focus wide and thought at a time. I do not let